System boot completed.
What up, guys? Welcome back to yet another episode. My name is Eddie Bear, and today we will continue on our journey down the whole Storage Guide 2018 lane, which kinda evolved to a Thunderbolt 3 storage guide comparison thing. Today we will take a close look on QNAP's new, let me get this right, TS-453BT3. By the way, QNAP, isn't there a better way to name your systems? This system from QNAP actually offers a lot of features and is kinda a crossover system, so this system will be the first NAS-based system in our test here, but it also offers direct attached features through its Thunderbolt 3 connectivity. But before we get ahead of ourselves, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also make sure to check out the fully written articles on eddie-bear.com. And without further ado, let's jump right in. Okay, so let's see what we have in this box. First of all, power plug as usual. Then we have a little box in here. I'm guessing accessories. So some instructions, a power brick, a nice little remote control for all the media features. We got a battery, some screws in there. Also included is an Ethernet cable and another Ethernet cable. So it's time to free this puppy out of its box. This unit is actually pretty small. I wasn't expecting it to be this slim of a design, to be honest.
On the bottom we find a one-touch copy button, then a USB 3.1 connector and two Thunderbolt 3 connectors. On the top we have the OLED display and the power button. On the back of the TS-453 you have the 10 gigabit Ethernet connector, two mic in, one line out, two HDMI connectors, two 1 gigabit Ethernet connectors, four USB 3.1 connectors, and of course, on the bottom, the power connector.
Okay, so here on the front, we have our OLED display that is actually giving us feedback about the TS-453BT3. Also, we have our four bays here in the front. In order to make them come out, you just have to push this little lid here, and then you can pull out the whole tray.
This sled is equipped with silicon dampeners and they will remove any unwanted vibrations from the drives you install in it.
Putting a drive into one of the sleds is actually pretty easy. You take the sled, pull this lid up, you take the mount out, take your drive, place it into the sled. Make sure that the holes align here on the silicon rubbers. Then you take your mount back, push it in, hear the click. And the moment it is clicking, it is mounted. So the QNAP TS-453BT3 not only offers a 10 gigabit connection, it also offers the ability to place two additional M.2 SSDs on the PCI Express card that is providing you with the 10 gigabit Ethernet.
In order to get access to the 10 gigabit card and the two additional SSD slots, we first need to remove parts of the chassis. For this, you have to take out three screws on the back. After you got rid of the three screws in the back, just push the lid of the housing backwards and then lift the whole thing up, but be careful not to use any unnecessary force. This card here takes care of the 10 gigabit Ethernet and the M.2 SSDs. The card is also secured with one additional screw in the back. Now you have to remove the four screws on the heatsink to get access to the M.2 SSD slots. Now let's throw some SSDs in there. Warning.
Here's a very important thing. Even though the slots on the PCI Express cards look like they support an NVMe M.2 SSD card, they actually don't. So don't even waste your time trying it. It does not work, trust me. I know things.
If you damage the heatsink compound on the processor, make sure to replace it with the ones that are in the accessory bag.
Before we jump into the benchmarks and test results, I wanted to clarify how the Thunderbolt connectivity actually works with the QNAP systems. So normal direct attached systems actually offer pretty much a connectivity like a USB drive. With the QNAP systems, it's kind of different. Through a Thunderbolt 3 cable, you are able to provide a device with, for one, power, Ethernet connectivity, and also a data stream. And QNAP is using this 40 gigabit of connectivity bandwidth that the Thunderbolt 3 cable is offering to provide your, let's say, a MacBook with a 10 gigabit Ethernet connection. So if you connect a QNAP device through Thunderbolt 3, it will actually not be connected as you are used to from normal direct attached storage devices. So it will establish a network connectivity, so your storage device will receive an IP address and you will have to mount the share that is actually provided by the storage device.
The easiest way to access the files on your QNAP TS-453BT3 is to use the QNAP Finder. It will automatically detect any QNAP device in your vicinity, whether it's connected through your network or through Thunderbolt. First, you have to authenticate yourself on the QNAP. Then you need to choose the network protocol. And if you're going to use the QNAP as a main video editing device, I recommend you to use the NFS protocol to get the fastest read and write speeds. Also, these settings can be adjusted anytime you want.
A little side note for today's setup. So the drives I used in this benchmark today were also used in last week's review of the Drobo 5D3. Naturally, this week I also redid the whole photo folder copy test, the video file copy test, and also the video file rendering test. All the tests today were conducted with NFS protocol and the volumes were set to static in order to achieve the highest possible performance. And the findings were quite interesting. So it looks like the Drobo 5D3 is really good optimized when it comes to photo archives. It is pretty much unbeatable when it comes to read and write speed, no matter it has an SSD accelerator installed or not. So with the QNAP TS-453BT3 in the photocopy test, I reached values
around 45 megabytes in write speed and 133 megabytes in read speed.
So this is considerably slower than it was with the Drobo 5D3. In the video file copy test, we reached values around 180 megabytes for the write speeds and somewhat around 200 megabytes for the read speeds. And this value is actually pretty interesting if you compare it to the Drobo 5D3, because the Drobo 5D3 last week was almost as fast as this device with an SSD accelerator attached to it. So actually, this means that the QNAP TS-453BT3 is really fast when it comes to video editing. And all the benchmarks I did in today's review were conducted under NFS protocols. But even though if I changed them to SIFS or SMB, these values didn't change too much. So it looks like the QNAP actually performs way better under video editing than it does under image processing. This could maybe change if you install an additional SSD tier, but unfortunately I did not have any SSDs that were supported by the QNAP. So QNAP, if you're listening, I would love to test this little fella with some SSDs in there, so maybe hit me up. And last but not least, a quick word about the video encoding capabilities. The MacBook Pro from late 2016 actually seems to be the bottleneck at this point. I know from a future review I will post soon that a way faster storage device is able to accelerate the encoding process, but not by far. So we almost reached also 17 minutes for the 4K, 14 minutes video, as we did last week with the Drobo 5T3. Since all the benchmarks are in, I don't want to keep you waiting any longer, so the QNAP TS-453BT3 scored a whooping 5,066 points in today's review, and here are the reasons why. If you're looking for a quick little editing device that you can place in your office and boots up quickly, then maybe the QNAP isn't the right device for you. The QNAP offers way more functionality than a normal local direct attached storage device actually is. So it offers you pretty much all the features a modern day NAS should offer any user. You can install all kinds of plugins on this system. It is even able to house virtual machines on it since it's powerful enough. Another thing I really like about the QNAP is the way they actually display information. You get all kinds of information about throughput, versions, and installed hardware and whatnot. And this is pretty much the most detailed infos I've ever seen in any device in my whole career. If you're having a small business or maybe a branch office with a limited number of users, this little QNAP box actually can take care of a lot of your needs. Although the QNAP TS-453BT3 offers a lot of features, I'm seriously missing one big feature with the whole QNAP lineup. And this is the fact that it is not able to expand its RAID arrays with different sized disks. So if you want to increase the storage in your device, you will have to switch all the hard drives that are installed within your storage. If QNAP would offer this feature within their storage devices, this would make their product superior to all the other Thunderbolt free storage devices out there. So QNAP, I'm hoping you're listening. So with all that said, what is your impression about the QNAP TS-453BT3? Is this a device you were actually looking for or maybe waiting for? Or are you considering some other Thunderbolt 3 device for your video editing or your file archives? Hit me up in the comments, and if you want to know something else about the QNAP, also let me know. So with that said, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.
Shutting down.